she watched him breathe.
Yep.
And her soul breathed life back into him.
I witnessed it. My name is Robert Patrick. I'm an actor. I'm currently employed on CBS's Scorpion, or perhaps you know me from Terminator 2 Judgment Day. Hi, Teresa.
Hi, how are you?
Welcome to my
home.
Very
nice to meet you. Thank you for having me.
Thank Absolutely. You have no problem coming up the canyon?
What do you think?
A little dicey, right?
I don't think you have to be a medium to know that it was a little dicey.
But welcome to the house.
Well, thank you for having me. This is very awesome.
Come on this way. I'll show you in. I do believe in mediums. I believe that people leave an impression on this earth. And this is very exciting to me because Teresa is probably the best.
I always want people, if they have specific questions, you know, you can always ask and do anything you want. Okay. But I like spirit to do most of the talking.
This is so great.
So have you ever been to a medium before?
I've had a psychic reading.
Oh,
would that be a medium?
I share on how I read. I connect with the souls of the departed.
Okay.
So I feel the emotional bond that you shared with them. Spirit will bring up things to make tomorrow a little bit easier. Not easy, just easier in knowing that they are with you.
What a positive experience this is gonna be.
Yeah, because that's what I want this to be. You ready?
I'm excited.
Where does the father come in that's departed?
The father has departed.
Okay. And who are you named after? Because he told me that you're a namesake as well.
I'm named after him.
Oh.
Yeah.
Did you just smell a cologne, or did you just change your cologne? Because your father says it stinks.
That is weird. That was 2 days ago, and I dropped a bottle of musk in my sink, and he's wrong. It doesn't stink. It's actually good stuff.
Well, he's saying it stinks.
Yeah.
So it's validating that he was there.
Wow.
For that exact moment.
Wow. I'm not so sure I want these people around me all the time.
No disrespect to my dad.
But look,
there are little things that go on that only we would know about.
Right.
That's it. I was a man of pride. When he first started channeling, he seemed a little like nervous. Like, I don't know, like if he knew what to do with me. And I felt he was very guarded with me at first. Like, who are you? Like, I don't know, you know.
Yeah, very unsure, doesn't want to embarrass himself.
And I told him, I said, whatever you make me feel is what I will say.
My dad was a good man.
Yeah.
He said, watching my family watch me be sick was one of the hardest things that I had to do. He took a hat and kind of pulled it over his eyes. So that's my symbol for where spirit really doesn't want to talk about something like that. Mm-hmm. He says, and with everything going on, I'm sorry for not telling you everything.
Right.
And I feel like it was in the beginning that happened where he wasn't saying anything.
Well, that's real deep. That's a deep, 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 deep.
I don't want to say that he was stubborn or, but like.
Pride.
These are the things that he's realized about himself on how things could have been different if he handled it differently.
Mm-hmm. That's very interesting.
He says, but I don't want anyone to carry that burden for me.
Mm-hmm.
He says, I take full responsibility for that.
That's definitely him.
He says,
we accept that. My dad died of cancer. He had cancer pretty bad. We didn't realize it was cancer until near the end. And the last time I saw him was Thanksgiving. And I called all my brothers and sisters and said, I don't think he's got very long. Whatever's going on, I don't think it is what he's telling me it is. And I do think you guys all need to get out here and see your father. And I'm glad I did that because my instincts were right, because 2 weeks later he was dead.
There's another soul stepping forward. It was a mother figure that stepped forward. So unless if it was your grandmother or mother-in-law.
Could be my wife's mother.
Okay, because they had me say mother-in-law. And who passed from the brain? Like either Alzheimer's, dementia, or they couldn't communicate in the end?
She did. She got mad cow's disease.
Who missed the departure?
My son.
So they overlapped, the birth and the, well, they were very close together, is that correct?
She was recently departed when my son was born.
There's something of what, could, she's watching me take the breath. She has me watching the breath. So there has to be something where someone was gonna go, supposed to go.
Oh, well, that's my son.
Okay.
He was in emergency C-section, and they had a prolapsed cord, and he wasn't breathing on his own. We went in to have Sammy born. The intern came in and was checking him in the womb, and the cord was prolapsed. And so we had this beautiful boy that was just laying there, not breathing, because the oxygen had been cut off to him, and he was crashing. They had kept telling me to, you know, sit down because, it wasn't looking good.
She said he is the miracle baby because he technically, medically, would have been very hard for him to survive that.
Yeah.
And what your mother-in-law showed me was just something so incredible. And what I felt was such a gift from God and, more importantly, love.
Yeah, well.
I watched her soul leave the physical body and move right through, and I watched her breathe into a baby.
Wow, that really is, it's amazing.
So know that your mother is acknowledging how she watched him breathe.
Yep.
And her soul breathed life back into him.
I witnessed it. I witnessed what she just said.
So know that that was real?
That's
know that
crazy.
That was her soul?
I was in Cedars and literally sitting there praying over my boy.
And you saw?
I saw him jerk and rip the oxygen right out of his face. He was in the NEO.
And then he breathed on his own. That was your mother-in-law, breathing life and giving him his soul to live a full life.
Wow. They wheeled him past me. They took him to the neonatal intensive care, and it was up there that I literally witnessed his first breath. You nailed it. You nailed it.
So know that when you say your mother-in-law, she didn't know of Samuel.
Yeah, she did. Thank you. I love hearing that. I've never sat with a medium before, and it was exciting. It really was exciting. That was amazing. I mean, everything that you, mm-hmm. everything that you brought forward.
So to be able to channel them, to feel them, to know, and to be able to interact with them, it's acknowledging that the souls are in a safe place.
Oh.
So I want to thank you for not only giving me the honor and privilege, but more importantly, for trusting me with the souls of your loved ones.
That was wonderful.
Thank you very
beautiful.
Much. Very
thank
nice
you.
To meet
very
you.
Very nice to meet you. You're wonderful. We're all just one big connection of souls traveling through this life. I've always believed it, and this was a validation that it really is true.